Alright, welcome back to Full Throttle TV and the Full Throttle Sim Racing League. Tonight we got the Blackwater Products USA Truck Series live from Las Vegas Motor Speedway. We got a great field here, 33 trucks going to try and tame this monster out here, and it's going to be one heck of a race, guys. Tonight I'm Dean Doucette. We've got Brad Patterson in the booth with me. Brad, we got Las Vegas tonight.
That's right. It's a far cry from last week at Daytona. We're going to see who can carry that momentum. Will it be a Spire, a Spear Motorsports truck, or maybe one of those Blackwater trucks coming to the front? It's a totally different game. You don't need a partner. It's you versus the track. We're going to see who can get the job done tonight.
Yeah, absolutely right. We also got some other great teams out here. We got Fury Motorsports out here, led by our league owner, Brody Hanna. We've got Team Marble Racing, and also we got Wheelin and Dealin, some new guys out here. They're going to be tough, led by Russell Charnowski there, and he looks real strong.
Yeah, a lot of the cars are turning in some really good lap times right now at the top of the leaderboard on the practice charts. You got Terry Cooper Jr., Jason Martin, Bobby Terrell, he's no stranger to the top of the field, as well as that 84 of John Adams. Last week's winner, Sherwood Williford, seems like he's putting up a good number. It's going to be a really interesting night. A lot of the cars seem to be very stable and within reach of each other, so it should be a fun night.
Yeah, we've got a great bunch of guys out here. A couple of guys who didn't show up last week, but checking in on the points, Sherwood Williford did win last week, and he's leading the way with his teammate Bernard Pearson in second, Terry Cooper Jr. in third, Stephen Loomis in fourth with a great run for him at Daytona, Michael Blackner in fifth, Casey McMullen Sr. sixth, Brian Helm, Jason Martin, Brandon Elder, and Brody Hanna round out the top 10 in the points. This series is just great, and they're going to battle all year long.
Absolutely. The first race was not going to be indicative of this series. You know, we had a little bit of cautions. We had a little bit of contrition, if you will. But this race, I expect to be a little bit more calm. But at the same time, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if we had a caution here or there. We got some new drivers in the field. But I expect for it to be a long green flag. Maybe that tire rule might even rear its ugly head in this particular race.
It might, and we'll get to that in a minute. Looking in on the race analysis, we've got a 100 lap race tonight, 150 miles. The corner banking is progressive, 12 to 20 degrees. And of course, this track opened in 1996. That's the mile and a half version. I believe that the actual track opened back in the 70s, maybe earlier than that. But 1996 on the mile and a half version. Getting into the keys to the race, which you just alluded to, Brad. We got early run, just meaning the first couple laps of every run. These cars are really loose, and they're really tough, especially in corner one and two. And you might see a couple of guys lose it there. So you got to have a heads up, not only for your own truck, but everybody else's track position. Course, this goes into conjunction with the third, which is the tire rule. You know, do you come in with early caution? Do you save those sets of tires? We have one on the truck and three sets in the garage. That's it. So some decisions will have to be made if there's some cautions, and track position could be huge tonight, Brad.
Yeah, absolutely. You have a really big mixed gamut here, and a lot of it's going to depend on cautions with that tire rule. You can basically do anywhere from 45 to 48 laps on a tank of fuel, so expect that you're going to have to pit once, at least twice, just for a splash. But depending on if the caution comes out, when it comes out, will you take tires? Will you gamble and try to save a set for later in the run for a late caution? It's really going to be the first time that these drivers are going to have to experience really setting up the race that way.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And I couldn't be happier that we're here at a mile and a half track. You know, Daytona's a lot of fun and everything, but this is where this league shines. A lot of green flag racing usually. If it's not, then the tire rule comes into effect. Really throws things out of whack. It'd be interesting to see, Brad, some of these new guys like a Russell Charnowski, a John Adams, a Larry Anderson, if these guys can adapt early enough, or is it going to take them a few weeks to understand just how this tire rule works, like we've seen maybe a Casey McMullen benefit from making certain decisions in the past.
Yeah, and don't get it wrong. Even the veterans in this league, you could have a mental lapse and all of a sudden be on the wrong end of a penalty because you ended up taking too many tires yourself. So it can really, it's something that really equalizes the field. Do you save your tires? Do you burn them up and really go all out? It's a great rule. It introduces a lot of strategy into your racing. And I'm really anxious to see what the drivers do with this tonight.
As am I. As we take a look in here on the 33 track of Sherwood Wilford, our points leader, as he's taking his first lap out here of qualifying. Looks like right now we got John Adams on the top of the board. No real surprise there. John, a former pro, great racer. As Terry Cooper Jr. just jumps ahead of him, and then David Skillhouse on top of that. So maybe those were the first laps as the board continues to change.
Yeah, really with the tires needing to come up to pressure, you're not really going to see the fastest laps that can be put down on these trucks. I would suggest probably if they had an additional lap after this, that lap would even be faster once they get a little bit of pressure in there. So it's going to be about maximizing what you have. It's right there, John Adams actually jumps back in front of Casey McMullen with a 30.164.
John incredibly fast. It's not going to be a big race for who's on the pole tonight, though, I don't believe. I think tire management's going to be huge. We've seen in practice guys coming from 5-7 seconds back, saving tires, and about 20-25 laps in, they're just light years ahead of everybody. So it's going to be very interesting to see who's saving, who's driving hard.
Yeah, absolutely. On top of that, it will make a big difference starting position, maybe not as far as pits, but if you're starting, you know, if the leader's coming out of two and you're just entering into one because you're far enough back, it's going to take quite a bit of tire wear to get through the field. And it's also going to take a little bit of luck to make sure that you don't end up in any damage. I mean, with the super speedway, you could pretty much blanket the field within a second. Someplace like Vegas here, you know, you're on, you're off the throttle. There could be a gap of 3 seconds from, you know, the green flag practically.
Yeah, that's most definitely true. Right now, we're going to take a quick commercial break. We'll come back and we'll set your starting order.
Coming up to the line, being chased, and it was Braden Johnson.
Unbelievable finish.
It was one thousandth of a second between them.
Green flag in the air. We are racing in the 2020 24 Hours of Daytona.
They go door to door for the feature race lead here on the last lap of the race. Side by side for the race lead in the final corner.
Down the back straightaway, three wide again for the race lead. This is unbelievable stuff here tonight.
Aloba is going to have to be very deep on the brakes, and he is very deep on the brakes. It's side by side through the corner. This is for the win.
It'll be side by side. Davies low, Ottinger high. To the very inside is Garrett Lowe. Four wide at the stripe.
For all he's worth here on this outside line, neck and neck. Who's gonna back out? Does anyone back out?
Verstappen starts to squeeze on the inside, and now he'll try and straight line it. Goes under the apron, drag race to the line. It's so close to call.
All right, welcome back as they conclude their qualifying attempts here. We take a quick look in on the starting order, and looks like John Adams is going to hold that pole, Brad.
Absolutely. He holds that pole with a 30.164, followed by Zach McDaniel and David Schillhouse. Both of those drivers are extremely close in times.
Yeah, definitely. David Schillhouse there putting up a great time, and Zach McDaniel slipped right in there into second.
That's right. Fourth is going to be followed by Casey McMullen. Fifth is Bobby Terrell. Sixth is going to be Terry Cooper Jr. Seventh, Bernard Pearson. Eighth is going to be Russell Charneski, followed by Tracy Powers. Brian Helm's going to run out your top 10.
we'll just take a look in at the rest of the field here, 11th through 20th there. You can see guys like Sherwood Williford, Stephen Loomis, who had a good day at Daytona, TJ Bartell, everybody rooting for TJ to have himself a good night, once again caught up in a wreck at Daytona. TJ really struck with the bad luck there. We see Brody Hanna back here in 19th.
So hey, dude, I'll tell you what, now's the moment of truth. The green flag, you're getting ready to roll off. Who do you got for this race here tonight?
Well, it's so hard to pick right now. You know, there's just so many new guys here with speed. Guys like Russell Chernesky, John Adams, Zach McDaniel, David Skillhouse. You know, you got the old crew of, you know, Casey McMullen, Bobby Terrell, Bernard Persson, Sherwood Williford, Brody Hanna. I mean, it's anybody's game here. We're really going to learn. I don't know what we learned at Daytona, but we're going to learn a lot here at Vegas. And I'm expecting one heck of a race. Different strategies. I look for a guy like John Adams to get out here and really tear it up. I don't think he's much. I mean, he's probably a good tire saver, but I think his mode is to go and go fast. And I think someone like a Casey McMullen will be dangerous tonight. Bobby Terrell, always extremely dangerous. But yeah, if I'm going to pick someone, I'll take that four truck. I mean, it's hard to bet against him.
Oh, absolutely. He's been consistent. All last season he was consistent. But you know what? If you take that four, I'm going to take that eight. I'm going to take Bernard Persons. I think he's going to have the truck that's going to do it. I think he's going to be able to settle in. Run some good lap times, not necessarily show his hand early, but keep out of trouble. I'll take the 8 to your 4.
All right. You're just going to double up and go with the 8. Bernard Persson, fantastic driver, former champion, and yeah, he's a threat at each and every track, so great pick there. And they're running nose to tail here with Bobby leading Bernie there, the 4 to the 8.
Yeah, I mean, there's so many threats to this race in all reality. I mean, we're really not going to know who's going to be the big dog, if you will, of this series for a couple of races. And there's so many good drivers in this series that I think it could really have multiple names.
Yes, absolutely. As we get started here, and John Adams, 84, leads him into one. Going to be a nice clean start down into one. David Skillhouse there right on his bumper in that 62 truck. Looks like we're clean through one and two, and that's always good. And we're always worried about these trucks, Brad, as they seem to be a tendency, especially on lap two, actually. One's not so bad, oddly enough, but on lap two, in one and two, these trucks will just, you'll lose the rear end on them.
Yeah, they just need to get a little bit of air pressure. I think you're going to see these guys take it easy for the first lap or two, just to try to get their truck underneath them to less stable into the ground. Some guys might take a little bit of unnecessary risk, but hopefully everybody keeps their head on. It just gives it a couple laps that the air pressure builds before they really start contending for anything. They're finding out three wide on that backstretch, so they're not wasting any time.
Yeah, we're trying to get a look back here at some of this action. We look back at like Lane Allen, a little behind him. You know, Jason Spear way at the back here. He's obviously conserving tires. Brandon Elder bringing up the rear. He must be saving him, or he's not bringing up the rear, but he's back here. Lots of good trucks here as they kind of get fanned out here in single file. Good to see. You can see everybody's kind of a little anxious here at the start of this race with these tires.
Yeah, like I said, I think you're going to have everybody right now just kind of feeling out what they got. It's a lot different from last week at the Super Speedway, you kind of had to go there. You had to kind of force the issue, if you will. Today, you're going to be a little bit more patient. You're going to have different agendas, guys wanting to save tires versus guys trying to want to make it through the field. I think in about 5 or 10 laps, you're going to really see the difference between the guys that they're setting up for the long run versus they're really trying to make their run right off the get-go.
So looking at our top five here, you got John Adams in first. David Skillhouse in second. Zach McDaniel is in third. Bobby Terrell in fourth. And Casey McMullen sitting in fifth with his teammate, Terry Cooper Jr., right behind him.
That's right. And then you got in the seventh position, you got that A-Truck of Bernard Person. He's just kind of watching over my pick. You know, that's my pick. He's watching over your guy, just making sure he doesn't let him get too far away. And I think this is also going to be one of those deals where you're going to kind of set the guy up in front of you. You're not going to force the issue, especially early on in this type of race. If you're not here at the end of the race, you're not going to win. So I think there's a lot of people being patient right now. As I say that, you get the 45 of Jason Powers going underneath the 20 of Russell Charneski, and he's really stuck it in there, and it seems like he's going to make it work in the middle of 3 and 4 here.
Yeah, Russell holding them off right now, doing a great job on that high line. You know, and getting back to it, something you were talking about there with the 8 and the 25, that's a little bit of our rivalry we had developing last week between Blackwater and Spear Motorsports. You know, those guys... They battle hard, and they've been battling hard for a couple of seasons now. And hopefully there's no bad blood there, and that, you know, with Bernard right behind the 25 truck.
Wow, these guys are professional. They know what's at stake here. They're not going to make anything foolish or do anything foolish. Once the race is over, you know, that's a different story. You might have some words or something like that. But on track, these guys are professionals. They're going to keep it classy.
Yeah, absolutely. As we watch John Adams continue to lead David Skillhouse here and Zach McDaniel in third, and they're kind of pulling away. Bobby Terrell's kind of hanging with him in fourth place.
Yeah, I think right now you're starting to see a little bit of that. You got guys that can score consistent fast laps, and then you might have something like Bobby Terrell, but he's kind of in that middle where he's trying to decide whether or not he really wants to try to stick with the guys or if he wants to back it off a little bit and save some tire. I mean, he's in the perfect position. He's got nobody really in front of him, nobody really behind him. He could just kind of ride there and save his foot.
Yeah, well, that's the thing here. These trucks are almost full out around the track here for, oh, maybe 15, 20 laps. And now, do you back off just a bit? Just, you know, breathe that throttle ever so slightly to save some tire, Brad, or do you just mat it and go as fast as you can?
Well, if you're in a position like the Ford truck of Bobby Terrell, you know, you got a half second to the car in front of you, but you got a full second to the car behind you. So all you want to do is, you know, it's a long race. If those three guys in front of you gets out a little bit further, it's not a big deal. You just want to maintain the gap behind you, if you will, without burning up your stuff. Because if you're able to manage those tires, the three in front of you, in theory, should come back to you. But you just don't want to get stuck in that melee behind you, because from 5th to 15th is right on top of each other, and you don't want to be back there.
Absolutely. As we checked in with Tracy Powers there, as he just scraped the wall, you know, as you try and swing that car out on entry before you make the entry, he just touched the wall. No real damage there, but sparks did fly. A little bit scary for the guys behind, probably.
Yeah, that's going to be it too. As we get further into this run, these guys are going to start arcing it off the floor a little bit closer to that wall, trying to stand to it. And then all of a sudden, one lap, it's just not going to turn, and it's just going to slide into the wall on the exit of the floor. That's the trick here. It's full rubber, full connection, and full grip, and then all of a sudden, it's not there. And it happens that quick.
It really does. Great field here tonight. As we check in on Jason Martin, started in 14th, currently back in 18th place. Jason is a solid racer. We haven't given him a lot of airtime over the last while, so we thought we'd check in on him. He's looking solid out there, perhaps saving a little tire.
Yeah, I think he's really just letting his truck come to him. He's just got to give it a little bit of time. He realizes this is a long race. There's nothing to win in this first stage. There's going to be a minimum one pit stop, most likely a caution. So it's a matter of saving your truck, maybe make an adjustment or two, and be up there and battle him.
He's right behind or right in front of him is the 14 truck, Lane Allen. Lane Allen's been an oncomer lately, a solid racer all around, but he's been doing a great job as of late, and he's looking pretty good out there.
Yeah, I think you're going to have a lot of guys right now that they're in that transition as we're... But it'll be 14 laps into it. So within the next 5 laps, you're really going to start seeing, I think, some comers and goers. You're going to see who played the tire game for the long haul, whose setup works a little bit better over the long haul. If you actually look at the top 4, The gaps are starting to come down. Bobby Terrell's under a second now. So the top five, with Terry Cooper Jr., he's actually starting to reel in the leaders. So you're starting to see that difference in the tire. And it's going to be interesting in the next 15 laps.
It really is, and it's really interesting. These guys kind of closing the gap in on the 84 truck here as he opens up a little gap here. But as you said, we're only 15 laps in, so these tires really start to diminish when you get into that 20 to 25 lap range. And we'll just see who burned them up and who hasn't. I mean, we all know Casey McMullen, really great tire saver. There's several of them out here, but he's shown to be maybe the best at it. And we'll kind of keep an eye on him and see how his progress is.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know what? Over the next 15 laps, you're going to get put to a choice, all right? So we know that we have three extra sets of tires in the garage. So do you short pit? Do you break it up into stages of three where you pit at like lap 30, maybe lap 35? You know with fuel, you're only going to have to pit once and probably a splash. Are you banking on no cautions? Are you banking on cautions? You know, we're really getting to the stage where it's mile and a half racing, it's tire rules, it's strategy. All of that's going to come as the 42 is actually going to get underneath David Chilas on the front stretch, going for second place.
Yeah, we got the 42 making a move here, Zach McDaniel, and he looks like he's going to take that spot. Great job by Zach McDaniel.
Yeah, David Chilas doesn't watch it. He's going to end up in fourth real quick as Bobby Charles right there as well.
Yeah, and this is what we're talking about, you know, perhaps burned up the stuff a little bit more than these trucks, as it looks like maybe all three of these guys are looking to get a spot away from the 62.
Yeah, exactly. Right now, it looks like the top six are kind of in their own, or I'm sorry, the top five are kind of in their own. It looks like the 62 is on the way towards the back. But the sixth place truck of Brown Persons, he's not really making up a lot of gap. So it's going to be interesting to see when exactly they fall off, because these lap times are going to fall off in a hurry as these guys start pedaling it.
Yeah, this group right here with the 8, 71, and the 20, three great drivers, we'll see, they seem to be on a similar tire strategy here, and these guys might be in prime position here by the time this run is ended.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, that slight battle between the 42 and the 62 is actually able to let the 84 John Adams get out just almost a second lead, but he's managed to stretch his lead over the top five now to where, again, just that slight side-by-side, having to get out of it a little bit more to make sure that you're not getting in the drivers, really stretched out the top five. They were blanketed in under a second. Now it's almost 2 seconds.
Yeah, we'll see here as the scoring loop on my screen had it at 93 at the line. Back to the 42 track, and we'll just see as he comes around whether he's gaining or losing.
Yeah, the nice thing about that 84 out front right now, even the 42, he's able to use the entire width of the racetrack. You're going to have guys further back in the pack that are still being contested. They're having to stay out of throttle a little bit more and make sure they don't slide into the gentleman to the outside or the inside. And that's really going to hurt their lap time. When you're out by yourself, you can use the entire track. Your car's pushing, you can set up the corner a little different. If it's loose, you can run a little wide. You can really do things that you don't get the opportunity to do when you're back in the pack.
As we see, David Skillhouse continues to fall back here in that 62 truck as Bernard Persson is by, Casey McMullen's by, and Russell Chernowski is looking to get by as well.
Yeah, that's a classic sign of he's probably burned up either that right front, and now the truck's starting to push. He's really having to get out of the throttle, or some of these other guys either had a better set as far as the long term, or they just managed the tires. I wouldn't be surprised if by the end of this he's somewhere in the teens. He's definitely going to be one of those guys that he may benefit from coming to pit road in the next 10 laps, do a short pit and try to flip the schedule on these guys.
Yeah, you never know. There's lots of strategies to be had, and that brings us kind of to gas mileage. So gas mileage in the neighborhood of 48 laps, I don't think anybody can stretch it to 50, but let's assume that someone might try now, and others definitely will not. Are they pitting on lap 33? Is that why John Adams is up here pushing a little harder, saying, I don't have to do a 48-lap run. I'm only doing 33.
Well, that's just it. I mean, that's the name of the game, isn't it? I mean, they look now, the 42 and the 4 starting to close back in on John Adams. Really, you've got to get the feel for the race. You know, do you think this is going to be a race where everybody's going to be caution-free? Because if you think we can do this caution-free, absolutely. You come in. You come in early. You get as much time on your competition as you can. Now, if it's something that you think that there might be a caution, you know, people that as the run goes on, they get a little bit more reckless, a little bit more squirrely, then you might want to push it and try to stay out as late as you can, hope for a caution. You know, some guy getting into pit road and it doesn't quite get down fast enough, expends that on the entry. Man, there's a ton of different ways to lose this race. And there's also a couple of different ways to win it.
Man, as the 62 continues to drop, as we watched William Long and Lane Allen get around him, and then Lane Allen got around the 12 of Will Long as well, he's looking really strong right now, that 14 truck.
I'll tell you what, you know who else is strong? That 42 is Zach McDaniel. He has caught our leader, and he is on the back door. He'll be looking to probably get by him on the entry to four here.
Yeah, Zach McDaniel looking to take the lead away from John Adams here as he goes to the inside bumper there.
That's right. The 84 just closes the door, just doesn't quite give him the exit that he needs. He's going to sit there and try to set him up down the front stretch again. He's going to have to draft on him. What he's going to have to watch out for is going into one and two. He's got to, there's some nasty little bumps. Oh, as the 84 actually throws a block on him. They got to watch out for the bumps in one and two. It can really upset the balance of that truck.
Yeah, a little bit risky this early in the race, trying to throw a block. And Zach McDaniel down to the inside here.
Yeah, it's just a matter of whether or not he's going to have the drive off being on the bottom, or if the 84 can pinch him down. It doesn't look like it, as the 42 of Zach McDaniel is going to take the lead.
Great job by that 42 truck. Put him on the point. Zach McDaniel, our new leader. And Bobby Terrell closing right in on this group.
Exactly. This is going to be a three-truck battle here soon. I think at the end of this, the 84 is going to be the one in third looking at the front two.
There's a good chance that that's true, but here we go. We're on lap 29. Not going to be hurt too bad if he's looking to pit on lap 33. It's going to be really interesting to see these strategies and try and keep track of these 33 trucks and who pits and who doesn't.
Yeah, absolutely. It's going to be more, I think it's going to get more hectic for me and you than it is for these drivers as the four is starting to use that apron, trying to cut a little bit of time out.
Well, we talked to the four pre-race, and he said last night, late after testing for all week long, he finally found a little something that may have helped his tire wear, may have helped his longevity in the run, and I think it's being proven out here right now.
Absolutely, because he's definitely got some longevity now. There's some people towards the back of the field. They're 10, 15 seconds back. They're really looking for a caution, I think. But most of them, it seems like we're going to have some good race and some good full tests. Hopefully we can go caution too.
Well, as we talk about comers and goers in these races, which there always is, we're looking at Lane Allen and Russell Chernesky here as they're starting to work on the 25 with Terry Cooper Jr., who just a few laps back was part of that lead group. Bernard Persson already gotten by him. And don't look now, but here comes a 71 of Case McMullen Jr.
Absolutely. You're starting to see the guys that decided to take a little bit of discretion out of valor, if you will. They weren't really worried about leading laps early. They're more worried about taking care of their equipment, making sure that they make it. And actually, it looks like the 14 was actually able to get by the 20. The 20 had a little bit of a bobble there, but they are really duking it out. And if you actually look back at the 26 of Brian Helm, they're just in a blanket of four trucks, including the 9 of Jason Martin. They're all over, three wide, contesting it in every single corner.
They are, as we looked at it, the 77 just behind them there is looked like he almost had a little problem there, getting a little bit loose perhaps.
Yeah, again, that exit of four, that's late, you get later in the run, and that's what you got to manage, especially when we're talking about short pitting. You know, are you worried about somebody coming off that corner and not being able to hold it?
Back there is our Team Marble car is coming alive. The 37 of Brian Conklin in that nice white truck, and followed by Tyler Marble, our youngest driver out here, who does a fantastic job in this series.
And speaking of goers, if you want to go ahead and come all the way back to the 17th position, you'll find the 62 of David Shorehouse. Remind you, this is a car that, that started at top four. And unfortunately, he wasn't able to, either from set-wise or just taking care of his tires, he wasn't able to take it. He's been dropping through the field.
Yeah, absolutely. And it looks like perhaps Tracy Powers, was he on pit road? Or did he have an incident? The 45 truck there, right, just got passed by our leader.
I don't know. I'm looking at the 51 of Brandon the Elder. He's actually coming back to pit road. He's a few laps down, so he might have been involved in an incident as well. We're going to have to look into that.
Well, we definitely have people pitting here, as David Hensley's into pit road right now. So some guys choosing to pit right here on, you know, lap 36, just a little bit north of lap 33.
Yeah, it's a good solid thing. If you're losing too much time and you decided that you're going to try to make up a little bit of time on the leaders, it's definitely a good time to do it. Now, what's going to be interesting is what the leaders do. Are they going to sit there and they're going to come in early to try to make sure they don't lose very much time, or are they content with just staying out and banking some of the time that they already have? Because they had quite a bit of time with some competitors.
Yeah, I'm telling you, Zach McDaniel here doing a great job. He was running up front the whole time, managed to overtake John Adams, so he saved a little tire somehow. And Casey McMullen, who'd saved basically the most, I believe, in fourth place, is really not making time on these guys at this point. So Zach McDaniel doing a fabulous job out front here.
Yeah, it seems like Zach McDaniel and John Adams lap times are about the same. Terrell and McMullen, they're about 0.2 slower a lap. They're not really losing anything, but they're definitely keeping everybody honest, if you will. I think it's only going to be a matter of time before the 4 and the 71 kind of pit road. And you know what? Hopefully they come a couple laps early, get a little bit more advantage on the first two. You definitely don't want to follow the first two in. You want to be the first one out of the top five to come to pit road to try to gain an advantage. I expect to see that within the next five laps.
Yeah, definitely. Like I said, I don't believe anybody's going to be trying to make it the distance of 50 laps to only do one pit stop, but you never do know. As we just looked in at all of our top 10 competitors, and I see TJ Bartell currently showing in 10th place. Nice little run for him.
Yeah, right now he's kind of riding out. He's got a lot of cars coming around him that obviously have fresh tires. And this is one of the things that you really got to be careful. You're going to have cars coming up on you. The closing gap on them is tremendous when they have fresh tires. It seems like you're getting passed by a truck doing 100 horsepower more than you. And all you can really do is hold it there.
As we got Bobby Terrell on pit lane on lap 40.
So this is where it gets good. The leaders are going to have to react to this, because if they do not react to this, if they sit out there for another 2-3 laps, he will overtake them. He was close enough to them.
So Bobby Terrell down safely in his pits. John Adams. Ooh, and it looks like perhaps that was just a computer issue. Seen a little smoke out of the back of the 84 truck there.
No, it looks like Casey McMullen saw that, and he's actually going to cover the move. He's going to come down pit road this time. Zach McDaniel and John Adams continue on the track.
Smart move by the 71 truck, as he realized his closing in on the leaders had stopped and everything had leveled out. So good chance here to get in, get some track position.
As the 42 and the 84 continue on, now I'm not going to say it's necessarily a bad move. They may be going for a little bit of a longer strategy, but they're definitely going to lose time to the 4 and to Casey McMullen out of this one. I expect them not to be in the top, not to be leading this essentially once we cycle through. It should definitely be either the 4 or Casey McMullen.
Now, when you look at these two guys, both new to the league, never really worked with a tire rule. You know, this is not a bad move as a 42 comes down right now.
Yeah, it seems like they're both coming down this time. They were just waiting on each other, it seems like. Now, here's where you really got to be on your P's and Q's, if you will. You got to make sure you get that get down to pit speed. You don't need a penalty. This looks like it's going to be a green flag stop, green flag race. So you really have to hit your marks.
looks like the 42 is in, the 84 is in, both safely in. So right now, that's going to put, guess who, in the lead? The 8 truck of Bernard Persson.
That's right. So you just can't go there. I mean, when you pick it right off the bat, it just works.
So it's interesting. We've seen leaders come in together. We've seen, Team Blackwater come in together. Here is Bernard Persson sitting out front here, and he's on a totally different strategy. I mean, he could catch a caution, be great for him right now. But also, the second two runs, he can do, 25 and 25 or something and just mat it.
Yeah, the one thing that he is losing, though, is right there, Bobby Trail's gone by him. Casey McMullen's going by him. He's got the 42 going by him. So he is losing a lot of time with this strategy. He really needs that caution for it to really work in his favor. Because the longer he stays out, he's losing time, not only to the front runners, but everybody else. This is one of those deals where it's a make it or break it.
Yeah, and we got a couple other cars. We talk about Team Spirit. Looks like they're all on the track with Sherwood Williford and Jason Spirit still on the track. I think David Hensley did pit. He's part of that team. We got Donnie Sawboats and David Skillhouse still out there. Stephen Loomis still out. Jared Carr, Will Long, Brian Helm, Kevin Sargent. So now, I don't know, but are these guys trying to make it to lap 50? This could be huge if they could do it.
If they could do it, it would be huge, but I don't think they're going to be able to do it. Right now, the battle for the lead is basically with the Ford truck of Bobby Turrell, who was able to leapfrog Zach McDaniel and John Adams, followed by Casey McMullen. But right now, these guys that haven't pitted, they were slower than the Ford truck, the 42 and the 84, and right now they're just giving up massive amounts of time. In order to get a victory, they're going to really need a caution. Otherwise, they could have just caught themselves being a lap down to the leaders.
Yeah, as we've seen, several of these guys are in the pits now, realizing they can't make it, or perhaps just fulfilling the strategy they already had. But there is still a lot of guys on the track. TJ Bartell, I believe Brody Hanna may be still on the track. Either that, or Brody Hanna, actually, at the rate he's moving, maybe just a scoring issue. He's either still on the track or he had a really early pit stop because he has moved up the leaderboard quite a bit.
No, I don't think so. I mean, looking at his lap times, the lap times are consistently falling. I think that you're going to sit there and you're going to see him in the next few laps come in.
So we look at Bobby Terrell here, probably our leader when this all shakes out. And the 42 truck, who was leading, is right behind him. Now, they didn't pit on the same lap. The 42 truck's got, maybe three laps on them, as well as the 84?
Yeah, probably about three laps. Now, that doesn't sound like a lot, but as far as the level of grip, it's definitely something different. Just kind of a side note, checking in on Brody Hanna. Right now, he's running 34-1s. He has not pitted. And if we sit there and we look at Bobby Terrell, who we know that's already pitted, who we assume is going to, come back with the lead, he's running a 30-80. So he's running 4 seconds a lap faster than Brody. That's how much time Brody is actually giving away to what will be the leader as he's actually coming to pit road now. I think he might even be out of gas because he got down on the apron before he even got into three. Oh, I think he was actually stretching it, trying to get to 50 laps, and he may have. Unfortunately, though, it looks like he ran out of gas getting there.
Well, that would be unfortunate. A couple of guys trying to sketch it. Brody Hanna, looks like David Skillhouse also pitting on lap 50. So these guys are desperately trying to make it to the end. I'm not sure, even if they can, that that's going to be a winning strategy, but not a bad choice when you start in, say, 19th place or wherever Brody Hanna started.
Yeah, we're going to have to see what scoring and timing does, because it looks like I just saw the 33 of Sherwood Williford come off pit lane under power. So he got in with maybe lap 49. It's just going to be a matter of how many laps down some of these people are, because and whether or not they can get green flags run in order to unlap themselves to where they are versus the leader, whether or not this is going to be something that's going to be a winning strategy or not.
we watch the 84 truck of John Adams continues to lead this race with the 42 who had passed him during the actually Bobby Terrell, sorry, the leader, 84 in second, the 42 is in third, and we got ourselves a good little battle here with these top three.
Yeah, definitely. Right now we got the top three. They got a little bit older tires versus the trucks around them, so they can't exactly get through the traffic as much as quick as they like. I'm sure the drivers are being courteous and respectful, trying to let them through. But what do you do when you're the driver on faster, fresher tires and the leader comes up to you? You got to run your own race.
You got to run your own race. There's a lot of trucks out here, a lot of points to be had, and you can't just simply give away spots and sacrifice a second or two a lap. I mean, you want to be courteous, but you want to race your own race.
Yeah, absolutely. This is when it can get a little tense too. You got drivers on different series, you got drivers on different schedules, different tires, you know, different closing rates. This is where all the drivers really have to be mindful for where they're at, or that caution will come out as you actually have the 84 on the back of the four truck right now.
Yeah, and you can see here Bobby kind of protecting. Now, you know, this is a little different. We're racing for the race lead here. This isn't a lap car. Is Bobby's not going to let him by very easily. He wants him to burn up the stuff down there, does he not?
Yeah, but Bobby understands too. He short pitted him a couple of laps. He understands the 84 is going to have a little bit of better tires. But at the same time, he has to sit there and he thinks back of the last run. Well, the 84 came out of a can really fast. Towards the end of that run, three quarters into it, he started backing up to him. So right now, if you look at Bobby, Bobby was able to actually be in front of him. So in his mind, I would think that he's not going to lose as much time and he'll be able to come back to it and get it back. What he's really got to worry about is that 42. That 42 truck seems like it gets better as the run goes.
He really does. And, you know, we had Case McMullen in fourth place. He was your first pitter, so don't think he's going to be a factor this run, but still a factor in this race. A lot can happen here as we continue to go green with 45 to go.
Yeah, I think that 42 is the fastest in the long run. I think that 84 is the fastest in the short run. But then again, you know, like you said, we haven't seen what the 71 of Casey McMillan can do, or even the 4 of Bobby Turrell when they're actually trying. Not that they're not trying, but as far as, you know, not having to worry about tire wear. So if we get a caution, it could be a shootout.
Absolutely could be, as a 42 continues to work on Bobby Terrell in that four truck. Not an easy pass here. Bobby's not going to roll over for anybody, and nor should he.
Absolutely. You got to earn every single spot in this league. And if you didn't, then there'd be something wrong with the league. Let's be honest. This is racing after all.
So John Adams continues on the point. That'll put Zach McDaniel in second and Bobby Terrell back to third. Casey McMullen in fourth. And Lane Allen, his teammate, is in fifth. He's about 12. Actually, Lane Allen looks like he is falling off the pace. Something happened with Lane Allen as I see some kind of smoke coming out the back end. Could have been just a little computer glitch there as he's back at 10 seconds now, back where he was. You never know with sim racing. Sometimes a little connection issue in the scoring loop kind of changes. But Lane Allen running in fifth place. And Russell Chernesky is in sixth. James Torrey is seventh. Terry Cooper Jr. is in eighth. Tim Bell's having a nice run in ninth. And Tyler Marble has made his way up to 10th place.
Absolutely. It seems like those guys are kind of in their own. Right now, it looks like the top four is really the class of the field. I mean, they've got 8 seconds on everybody. And really, we're talking about the top three. We got another second and a half back to the 71 in Casey McMullen. And then everybody's kind of staying honest between 5th to 10th, if you will. And then we get a little bit more gaps. Unfortunately, we're along in the 12 car and 18th. It seems to be the first car run that down. Now, if you're one of those guys, you know, once you hit that pit mark, you know, do you short pit? You know, lap 51, 52, do you come in? Do you go ahead and try to play the ultimate gamble and flip the script to the guys at the end? We know that the leaders are going to have to pit again. We know everybody is going to have to pit again without a caution. So do you just go for broke? You're lapped down, you're counted out. You know, what can you do to get yourself back into contention, or at least back on the lead lap to get a couple of spots?
Yeah, it's all about what you're looking for. If you're looking for a solid points night, maybe you just do what the leaders do or do the standard 33 lap thing. Or if you really want to win this race, and you can't necessarily beat the top two or three guys, you got to get off sequence. If they're staying out, you go in early. If they come in early, you stay out late. You got to do something different. Maybe hope for a caution. Maybe hope there's a problem. And, you know, there's no risk, no reward in racing.
Absolutely. I mean, if you're the 83 or the 17 right now, you're looking in the mirror, you're seeing the leader coming, you're seeing the 84 coming. You have nothing to lose to duck in there to get in the pit road. Literally, if you're somebody more like the 8 truck or Brown person, she's 18 seconds back from the leader. So he's got about 15 seconds on the leader. Go ahead, make the gamble if that's what you want. And if that's what you're going for, you're far enough ahead. You should be able to, in theory, make up the time. You should finish on the lead lap if it goes green. If it doesn't go green, you're in a different situation. You're in a different pile. But right now, this race looks like it's going to go green. I'm very happy to see that, especially after last week, a little bit of cautions. We're being able to see a different couple of different strategies. And if you're the 4 truck of Bobby Turtle, you really have the option. You know, you're a second and a half back. You're starting to hemorrhage time to the leaders. You're in your pit window. This could be the race for you. What do you do?
Yeah, but he also was in first last time. It's not working for him, so I don't know. He's got to be a little frustrated right now. With third place, solid. But John Adams continuing to lead, doing a great job here this run, holding off Zach McDaniel. And this is about the point in the first run where Zach passed him. So maybe John learned a little something.
I don't know. That 42 looks pretty strong. It looks like it's starting to make some little headways. Not a lot. I mean, a little corner here, a little corner there, a tenth here, a tenth there. It just seems like he gets off the corners a little bit better. And it seems like he can dime in the corner a little bit better. The 84 is running right on that bottom where the 42 is able to just kind of arc it in a little bit more. And on top of that, 84 has got to deal with that lap traffic. He doesn't really get a choice of where he goes. The 42 is able to kind of sit back and, you know, take advantage if the wrong move happens.
Yeah, you're absolutely correct. As you know, we are looking in at our scoring. It seems to be keep messing up for some reason. Not typical of the scoring board here, but the positions are correct. Times aren't necessarily correct. As I think the most correct we have is Tyler Marble in ninth is 16 seconds back. Now, I'm not sure where Lane Allen is. Maybe you can tell me, Brad. Lane Allen has been strong all night, and the longer the run goes on, the better he got.
Yeah, Lane Allen's currently in the fifth position. He's about 11 seconds back of the leader. He's kind of in his own. He's got Russell Charneski about a second back from him, but the leaders are a good 6 seconds ahead of him. So he's kind of in that no man's land where, you know, he's hoping for a caution. I mean, he's had a solid truck all night. He's able to make up a little bit of ground. It seems like he's actually pulling back some time from the leaders. But he really needs a caution if he's going to try to get into it to win. Or he needs to pull a strategy move. Even if he pitted right now, if it went green, it would be a stretch on whether or not he can make the time up on the leaders. Because I'm expecting leaders now to, you know, gas and go, maybe 2-tire stop. I don't expect them to spend a full 4-tire stop when they only need, you know, probably 3-4 laps of fuel.
As while we were talking and looking at a few things here, Zach McDaniel did make that pass. Put Zach McDaniel back to the point here, our new race leader, looking like this is his race to lose tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. If you look at the difference between the 42 and the 84, especially off of 4, you can see it. The 42 is really into the track. It comes off the corner nicely. With the 84, you can just see that truck's pushing a little bit. It pushes out to the wall. It yaws out a little bit in between on the exit of 2. But definitely on 3 and 4, on the exit of 4, it pushes directly to the wall where the 42 is able to put the power down. He's already given up 3/10 of a second to John. Zach McDaniel, and I expect that to increase.
Yeah, it's funny you say about the truck yawing out. We just seen him there basically dirt tracking it through 2, and so he's got a little bit of an ill handling truck, has perhaps made an adjustment, and he's doing it again. You're right, that thing is really yawing out there.
Yeah, I mean, he could ultimately come to pit road right now and really put the entire field on notice, because if you get a fast truck like that pitting from the lead, you know, he's going to be laying down some monster lap time. 30 laps to go. You know, you can run full out, not even really have to worry about it. You know, you might have a couple of outliners, some of the guys running in the back. You do have a couple of trucks coming to pit road. It looks like the 43 of David Hensley actually just left pit road. So we'll have to keep an eye on him to see what kind of lap times he's able to do and whether or not it's able to work out for him a little bit better. But ultimately, you can force other people to do something right now.
So we take a look in at the 77 truck here of Tim Bills. Started in 23rd tonight. Currently running in 6th place, Brad. Good run for that 77 truck.
Oh, absolutely. He's probably one of the biggest movers of the night. He's been solid. He's been consistent. Stayed out of trouble. And he's just keeping this truck underneath him there. 16 seconds back to the leader. He's currently actually got by the 4 truck of Bobby Terrell.
Bobby's on pit road right now. Just coming off of pit road.
That one's going to be interesting, I think, because that one could. He was 4 seconds back, I believe, when he went to pit road. That one could affect the end of this race.
Well, it almost affected something there, as I'm not sure who that was who just got by him. The 19 truck there. A little hairy, but good job by the 19 avoiding the 4 there coming off the pit road.
Okay, so it looks like Lane Allen actually just came to pit road, too. He's actually in pit road as well.
Yeah, I think you're going to see a lot of guys coming down. Once it starts, it's usually a chain reaction. But out front, the 42 truck, Zach McDaniel, continues to lead. Now, these guys here who just pitted, I don't know what they want. I mean, you're going to have to hope that once these guys pit, a caution comes out right away, and maybe you gain that position on them. We'll see just how long the 42 truck stays out, as I believe John Adams is on pit road right now.
Yeah, that's almost going to force the hand of the 42. Yep, as he comes to pit road right now.
And that's our leader, Zach McDaniel, down pit road right now.
So what we really need to do is we need to see where the 4 truck of Bobby Terrell comes out. He should be coming around right now to unlap himself. I think that the 42 is going to end up with the lead. The 4 truck didn't get enough laps underneath him to really get the advantage that he was looking for. He'll probably come out in 3rd. I think you're going to stay quo with the 42 and the 84 with the 4 following.
Well, we'll stay with the 42 truck here and follow him out and just kind of see where Bobby Terrell fits into this, as he's down and away here.
And John Adams is just hitting the start finish line right now, as he pitted 1 lap prior. The 42 had about a second and a half on him, as he's in the middle of 1 and 2, so that's really where the race is. Bobby Terrell still looks to be a good 5 seconds back, as the 84 will go by the 42.
Interesting. The 42 will have to pass him yet again. He's got to be getting sick of doing this.
Yeah, I think this is going to be the biggest advantage that the 84 has in the 42.
The 42 is back on pit road. The 42 with a penalty down on pit road has to come back in. This is going to blow his race. Zach McDaniel just leading the field. Really dominant truck. He has got to be just ticked right off.
Yeah, that's a disaster. I mean, nobody, you know, anybody will win it like that, but nobody wants to make that mistake. And I'm sure that there's a lot of things flying right now on that keyboard.
Wow, the 42 still sitting on pit road. Not sure how long he's going to sit here. We'll stay with him for a few seconds, see what kind of penalty he had to serve. That is going to kill his race. We'll try and keep an eye on him and give you an update on that. So we look back in at the 4 truck and then the 84. John Adams now going to be, when this cycle's through, like right now, your man, Bernard Persson, leading this race. But the 84 truck, this is his race to lose now. I mean, he had such a battle going with Zach McDaniel. What a shame this is.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it was shaping up to be a fabulous race. Bobby Terrell, he's 4 seconds back off of John Adams. This is definitely his to lose. He can actually back it off a little bit. Currently, John Adams is running a 30-60. Bernard Persson is actually on pit road right now, so that's not going to be any type of factor. The closest truck is the 62. of David Shellhouse, and he's running a 31.7, so he's averaging over a second and a half a lap, and there's enough laps for him to catch him. So
yeah,
I think it's a matter of just laps counting down and whether or not there'll be a caution.
Yeah, David Shellhouse going to try and make it, I believe, and he'll get a net gain out of this, but he is not going to win this race. John Adams is closing too fast with 22 to go.
Yeah, I think the only one you really have to watch for is Sherwood. Sherwood, I know, pitted on lap 49. He may be the closest truck to be able to make it, but I think that's kind of the same thing. He's running a 31.9 lap time. He's not going to win the race based upon his lap time. I mean, John Adams is only about 3 seconds behind him. He may be able to stretch it to get himself a top five out of this.
Yeah, and he'd be more than happy with that on a gas mileage run, but he's going to have to make it. Any pit will be a disaster for the 33 at this point. And Jared Carr is still out on the track, the 66. We haven't looked in on him tonight. He's right there with Sherwood Williford. I think both these guys running that strategy. Hard to tell for sure.
Yeah, I think they're both on the same. And they're having good nights, and really everybody in this race is having a good night. I mean, you know, they might not be in the position they're in, but they've run a fantastic race with zero cautions. Everybody's been really courteous. Everybody's really doing a good job. It's the 33 of Sherwood Williford actually peels off the pit road.
Yeah, he's not going to try and stretch it. As we watch 84 there, split the middle of two cars. You know, you never want to see the leader put himself in such a hairy position, but he made easy work of it. John Adams, a true pro, no problem for him.
Yeah, I can tell you, there's a lot of people on this track that would love to have a caution. Nobody more than Donnie Stavitz. The 99 of Donnie Stavitz in the lead. He's had an up and down night, started from the 25th position. He's finally found himself in the lead. He's getting himself some nice bonus points for leading some laps. He would definitely love a caution. He'd love to be able to bring that 99 in and get some fresh four fresh tires and chop a lot of cars a lap down and fight for a top 10.
Yeah, Donnie, a part of that original Blackwater Products USA team, who also are sponsoring this race. Don't forget to go check them out, guys. Check out their Facebook page. They got a lot of great products there. Please go check them out.
Yeah, absolutely. If it wasn't for them, we wouldn't be able to do what we do. But at the same time, he's still got a good couple of seconds. He's only got 3 seconds. The 84 is going to be on top of him for too long. So now he's going to start thinking about the long-term decision here. The longer he stays out, the more positions he's going to lose. If he can't get that caution in the next 4 or 5 laps, he's really just going to be tanking down the order. And I think he knows that, and I think now he's just in it for the long run.
So as the only contender really left is Donnie Stavitz, as the 84 now closing in on David Shellhouse, he's about to put him back down to third, and it'll be just Donnie Stavitz left for him. We'll see what Donnie can do out there. I mean, it's hard to believe these guys have gone green, but we know these full throttle sim racing league guys, they're the best of the best at clean racing, man, hard racing, got skilled drivers out here. I mean, it's hard to say it would be a surprise if they went green, Brad.
No, I can't say that they're not going to go green, and I really hope they don't, just for to show a testament to these guys and their driving ability. But at the same time, you know, if you're the Ford truck in Bobbitore, you've had a fast truck all night, you're 4 seconds back of the leader. You have the 71 of Casey Grimolin, he's 4.5 seconds back from the leader. You got somebody like a Lane Allen, a Russell Chernesky. You know, they would all love for a caution to come out and be able to sit there and come and get four fresh tires and really race for this win. You know, I'm not going to say that I wouldn't mind a little competition caution right now, but your hat's got to be off to the 84 John Adams. He's run an excellent race. He's the leader of this race right now, and he's done it through the entire night. He's been one of the fastest trucks all night, and he's been consistent, so my hat's off to him.
Yeah, absolutely correct. So John Adams, the 84 truck, continues lead. David Shellhouse in second. Bobby Terrell third, Casey McMullen fourth, Lane Allen in fifth, Russell Chernesky is in sixth, Tim Bills seventh, Tyler Marble eighth, James Torrey ninth, and your pick, Bernard Persson, sitting back in tenth, probably the freshest tires, so he's still on the move, I believe.
Yeah. I don't think, actually looking back, the 62 is yet to pit. So he's also one of those drivers that's on the long-term strategy as he comes to pit road right now.
It seems like whenever you say that, they just come down.
Well, the 84 hasn't pitted yet. How about that?
The 84 has pitted, so he's...
Yeah, good. Well, I was hoping.
As he continues to lead Bobby Terrell by 4 to 5 seconds here, and John Adams doing a heck of a job out here. Really unfortunate for the 42 truck of Zach McDaniel. Take a look in on him. He's still out here. Currently, I think he might be 2 laps down. How unfortunate.
He's 2 laps down, and he's still a very fast truck. I mean, Dennis Thomas just came out of the pit road with fresh tires, and the 42 is able to maneuver to the inside of him. That tells you how strong of a truck he had. And he's just really got to be, he's got to know that he let him get away, but at the same time, hopefully he'll take away from this that he had a really strong truck. And, you know, it's race two in the season. He's got plenty of time to make up the ground, and he could have had one for sure.
It was his race to lose. Unfortunately, him or his pit crew did lose it. And, you know, he's going to be really upset. But he'll come back, and he'll be here next week, and he'll do a fantastic job.
I'll tell you, a little friendly battle is starting to come up. Is that 4 and that 71, the 4 of Bobby Terrell and the 71 of Casey McMullen. That's going to be a race in the next few laps. They're consistently starting to come a little bit together. Casey McMullen's chipping away just a little bit at a time. I think that's probably the most contested race on the track right now.
You know, that's funny because these guys were practicing the other day together and they were doing the exact same thing. Very comparable cars. They run the same way in these trucks. And as you can see, here we are 91 laps in and they're virtually on the same exact speed here.
I'll tell you what, I almost don't even want to say it, but if we look at the that fourth place driver, because I don't want to say his name, for lack of a curse, he's having a hell of a night though. He's started 13th, he's running solid lap times, he's been there all night, and he's looking to do a very good finish and walk away with the top 5.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. We were just looking in on him when you said that. The 14 truck, Lane Allen, what a great night. Started 13th, currently 4th. Just, whoa, as he makes a bit of a violent move there on entry.
I told you, I didn't want to
say it. I said his name. Maybe that was
right.
That's all I get is a bobble. If you said it, maybe it's more. I don't know. But Lane Allen, great job.
I'm not saying it. If something happens, that one's on you.
Yeah, we're very happy with the progress Lane Allen's been making. I mean, this is a veteran of racing. I shouldn't call it progress. He just seems to have found a comfort level to show some more aggression, and it's paying off. He's consistently now showing in the top 5 of races across the board in 3 series, and just fantastic to see.
And you know what else it's good to see? It's good to see a couple of names that last week had bad... unfortunately, they went out early in the race. You had 77 Tim Bills. He's doing excellent. Tyler Marvel, James Torrey. I know he was involved in one of the early incidents last week. He's having a solid top 10 tonight run. So you got a lot of people that they're just trying to claw back some points, get back into this championship, and they're able to do that. So it's looking like a good night for some people. Of course, the 84 John Adams, you know, he's kind of the class of the field right now as we close in on the final laps of this race that it looks like it's going to go green.
Yeah, and, you know, another guy who snuck his way into the top 10 quietly here, which he always does. He's always quiet. You barely ever give him airtime, and he's always there at the end. The 55 truck, Jeff Bratton, coming from 31st, currently shown in 10th place.
Oh, absolutely. He's rocking that old school Rusty Wallace Miller Genuine Draft truck, and it's a beauty, and he's run a beautiful race tonight, being able to come back from the 31st position on the track. He is by far the biggest mover of the race right now.
He is. It's John Adams continues to lead. 4 to go, coming down to 3 to go here. And this is his race to lose. We got Bobby Terrell in second, Casey McMullen third, Lane Allen, and Russell Charnuski in the top 5.
Now, what'll be interesting is, and we haven't really looked into this, how many of these guys have really been trying to stretch it? We may end up with a caution with one or two laps to go from a car that was really trying to stretch the fuel and all of a sudden ran out of fuel and caused an incident. This could still happen.
It absolutely could happen. Anything can happen. I've never counted my chickens before they hatch, as they say. You know, I've seen cautions on the last lap and changes everything. And we see guy, you know, a driver come from fourth or fifth on the restart. Guys get loose and take this win away. I don't think it's going to happen tonight, as 84 is leading him down with two to go. He'll head into corner number three and come out looking for one to go.
John Adams comes off of turn four, pushes it a little bit to the outside. We actually get a couple of trucks going to pit lane. Doesn't look like it's going to be an issue. He's going to take the white flag and head into one.
Yeah, John Adams out of two safely. Started on the pole. Looks like he's going to end on the point. That 84 truck, good looking truck, man.
Yeah, absolutely. As he comes off turn four, he's going to see the checkered flag as a couple of cars seems to be running out of fuel around him.
Yeah, Brody Hannah running out of fuel. Our race winner tonight, the 84 truck, John Adams, returns to FTSR Racing. He was here back way back in 2003 as an original member, makes his return a victorious one. We couldn't be happier to see John Adams back out on the track, as you see Brody Hannah come down there. Whoa, it gives him a little more than a tap. He's gonna take him out. Oh wow, just trying to give him a friendly rub, and unfortunately that was a little bit more than a rub.
Yeah, that's gonna make for an interesting interview.
It really is. I'm not sure if there's a message sent there. No, there's no message. Brody Hannah trying to be nice, trying to just be friendly. A little harder maybe in sim racing to do that than it is in real life, but add a little levity to the moment anyway.
Well, you know what they say, if you can't take the congratulations, don't do something. As the 84 lights him up, and he's really caps off a wonderful night where these guys went green flag, flag to flag, no incidents as he blows the motor. There might be a little bit something there to maybe a little bit of help from Brody Hannah on that one.
Yeah, I think there was. John Adams, man, our race winner tonight. Another fantastic race for these guys at Full Throttle Sim Racing, Brad. I mean, green flag racing, you just don't see it on iRacing, on open server, and you don't see it much in many of the leagues. But here at FTSR, it's almost constant. These guys just do not crash, and they do it with talented guys. It's not like they're creeping around this track. We got several guys that can race with anybody here.
Absolutely, and it's really a testament to the drivers. I mean, they all treat each other with respect, give each other enough room to get by and to do what they need to do. But at the end of the day, you know, we're all here to race. We're all here to put on a good show and be here for everybody. John Adams was the class of the field this evening, but we had a lot of good battles throughout the night. Unfortunate for the 42 is Zach McDaniel. I mean, my heart really goes out to him. He was in the cat bridge seat. He was right there. This could have been a totally different race, but unfortunately, it all slipped away on pit road.
Yeah, it really could have been a lot different. Feel bad for Zach. But right now, we'll take a short commercial break. We'll come back. We'll do our race recap. We'll do the whole rundown of the field. And we'll get some post-race interviews with our top three finishers. We'll be right back.
Coming up to the line, being chased, and it was Braden Johnson.
Unbelievable finish.
It was 1/1000th of a second between them.
Green flag in the air. We are racing in the 2020 24 Hours of Daytona.
They go door to door for the feature race lead here on the last lap of the race. For the race lead in the final corner at Homestead.
Down the back straightaway, three wide again for the race lead. This is unbelievable stuff here tonight.
Aloba is going to have to be very deep on the brakes, and he is very deep on the brakes. It's side by side through the corner. This is for the win.
be side by side. Davies low, Ottinger high. To the very inside is Garrett low. Four wide at the stripe.
All he's with here on this outside line, neck and neck. Who's gonna back out? Does anyone back out?
Verstappen starts to squeeze on the inside, and now he'll try and straight line it. Goes under the apron, drag race to the line. It's so close to call.
All right, welcome back. And what a great race we had here. Let's get right into the race results here. Our winner tonight, the 84 truck of John Adams, doing a masterful job tonight. Had a big challenge from the 42 of Zach McDaniel. Fortunately, Zach, problem on pit road. John comes home the victory. Might have had it anyway. It's going to be a hell of a battle. Bobby Terrell coming home in second place in that familiar Ford truck. Had a great run. Just maybe not quite enough for the leaders. Tried some pit strategy, didn't quite work out. Casey McMullen tried a couple of different things. He'll take home third. Lane Allen, maybe one of our best movers of the night in that 14 truck. What a great run for him in fourth place. Russell Chernesky had a really nice finish for the 20 truck. A good showing in fifth place. Tim Bills, man, can't say enough about Tim Bills tonight in the 77 truck. Great run for him in sixth. Tyler Marble, coming all the way back up to seventh place. Great run for the kid, Tyler Marble. Bernard Pearson, your pick tonight. He'll come home in eighth. James Torrey in ninth. And Jeff Bratton, who come all the way back from 31st spot to finish 10th. Great run by him. Looking at 11th through 20th, we've got Jason Spear, Sherwood Williford, Jared Carr, David Skillhouse, William Long, Donnie Stavots, Kevin Sargent, Larry Anderson, Michael Blackner, and Terry Cooper Jr.
That's right. It's going to follow out the end of our field. We're going to have Brody Hanna in 21st, followed by Daryl Spear. Zach McDaniel, unfortunately, in that 42 truck. He was a runner all night, raced with the leader, and unfortunately had that problem on pit road, followed by David Hensley, Brian Helm, Paul Sargent, Steve Loomis, TJ Bartel, Jason Martin, Brian Conklin, Tracy Powers, Richard Hines, and Brandon Elder rounds out our field.
Yeah, really solid race by everybody tonight. And, you know, green flag here at Las Vegas. This league always going green. And just a great race. I mean, we didn't have the caution, so the tire rule didn't come up, Brad. I mean, I don't ever wish for cautions, but I really love it when the tire rule mixes things up. But we did have guys trying different strategies, and we did have movers, comers, and goers. Maybe not exactly at the front always, but guys like Lane Allen. We've seen Tyler Marble make a move, Jeff Bratton make a move. So there was, and Tim Bills up there in sixth place. So there was comers and goers tonight as well.
Oh, absolutely. These guys did put on an incredible race. They were able to keep it clean and stay green. You had guys coming from the tail end of the field with Jeff Bratton there in 31st, managing to finish in the top 10. You had some guys that were able to stay on point. John Adams winning it from the pole, essentially. It was a great race all the way around. Unfortunately, we had some pit road issues that took away some contenders. We had some different strategies. It was great all the way around.
It really was. And speaking of different strategies, someone who's really been masterful at different strategies in this truck series in particular, Mr. Casey McMullen Sr. Casey, hey, great job, man. Third place. Tough group up there to battle.
Yeah, thanks. I'm pretty happy with my result. Didn't have the speed tonight, but we had a solid long run truck.
You did. Now, we were, you know, you, at times you like to save tire. Talk a little bit about the race and your objective there. I'm not sure where you started exactly, around fifth or something, fell back a little bit, then closed back in. Were you saving tire? Were you saving enough tire? Was it too hard to save tire with the shorter run? Just talk about that a little bit.
Yeah, I didn't save enough tire tonight. But, I'm sorry. I saved too much tire my first run. And the other runs, I didn't save tire at all.
Right, with the 100 laps kind of broken up to 33 lap runs, give or take, it was a little bit tougher to get on that strategy and make it work. We've seen Zach McDaniel, though, somehow saving a little enough tire to get by our leader and take the lead there twice in two separate runs. Talk a little bit about what you've seen out of maybe a John Adams, Bobby Terrell, Zach McDaniel.
Yeah, I think me and Bobby were about the same. But the other two, they were fast, and we didn't have the speed to match it. We just kind of lucked out getting the top three, expecting top five. I think the 42 got a pit road speeding penalty. But those two were fast. They were the class of the field, and they did a good job. Hats off to those guys.
Yeah, absolutely. And you did a great job in your Blackwater Products USA truck. You know, they sponsored the series. A great bunch of guys over there with Steve Berry leading the way. But a teammate of yours at Blackwater Motorsports, Lane Allen, also a great showing, closing up to fourth place.
Yeah, Lane's done real good this year. Was real good last year. It's just some of his finishes didn't show his speed, and tonight he got to prove what he has.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, well, congratulations on a third place finish, man. It's going to be a great points night. You're going to be in contention all series long, and we look forward to watching you, Casey.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate everything you do, and it was a good race. Congrats to John Adams, and check out blackwaterproductsusa.com.
All right, that was Casey McMullen, Brad. A nice little run for him, third place. You take that just about any night here at FTSR.
Oh, definitely. You know, to walk away with the top three finish in this particular field is always an accomplishment, and you'll be able to walk away with some good points. But I'll tell you what, right now I'm with the number four truck, Bobby Terrell, the slightly dangerous truck. He was able to walk away runner-up. Bobby, you had an excellent race. It seemed like right off the bat you were trying to save a little bit of tire, and then you were able to pull a little bit of pit strategy on that first one with a little short pit. What did you need to really track down that 84 and the 42 early on?
I didn't have the speed they had. I mean, that's just the bottom line. I knew it, you know, when we got going and got started, it really didn't matter how much I saved. I just didn't have the speed. So, I just didn't have the speed in the truck. I mean, it is what it is. You know, I got lucky with getting second with Zach, I think got a speeding penalty, but those two guys were the class of the field.
Yeah, they certainly were. It seemed like they had some really fast trucks. I was kind of hoping that maybe we'd be able to get a late caution. I wasn't sure if you were quite saving at the get-go. I knew the strategy you were playing with, a little bit of short pit. The first one, it was really able to materialize for you, and you were able to get out and lead some laps. The second one, it just didn't seem like there was enough laps between yourself and the 84 and the 42 pit. And is there anything that you think that you do a little bit different as far as strategy wise, or you know, we pretty much just right where you think you ended up?
No, I mean, I would have been closer to them two guys even though I didn't have the speed short pitting like I did. I was getting a little bit loose on the first run, and when I pitted, you know, short pitted there, I thought I was tightening it up, but I went the opposite direction and made it loose. So I just got behind because it was so loose that second run. And then the third run, I went back the right way with it, and it was a lot better.
Yeah, that's one of the bad things, if you will, of green flag racing, is you don't get very many opportunities to work in a truck. But I'll tell you what, you had a rocket ship. You know, it might not have been fast enough to get with that 84 and the 42, but you were definitely one of the faster trucks tonight, and it was really enjoyable watching you race. And I'll just kind of turn it over to you if you got anybody to thank or anybody to say, and congratulations on a runner-up finish.
Thank you, sir. I just want to thank Full Throttle, you know, all the guys, the admins, for doing this. I mean, it's a big job. You guys up in the booth, you know, for what y'all do. The sponsor, I believe, Blackwater. And that's it. And thank you.
All right. And that was Bobby Terrell in the number four truck on the slightly dangerous truck. He had a really great race tonight. But you know what? I got Dean standing by with tonight's winner, John Adams.
Yeah, John Adams, one better than Bobby. John, congratulations on the win tonight, man. Great truck, great run. You know, you had a great battle going with the 42. He had a little problem on pit road, a little penalty there, but that doesn't take anything away from you, man. Congrats on the victory tonight.
Hey, I appreciate it, Dean. Yeah, I know that would have been a really good race there with Zach if he didn't speed on pit road. I had no idea what happened to him, actually. I had to go back and look to see what happened to him, because on that last run there, I was trying to short pit so I could gain some track time on him, because I had a faster short run truck than he did. He had a faster setup on the long run there. After about lap 20, I mean, I don't know, like, my truck was just getting so loose on the long run there, I just couldn't even hold on to it. I had to back out of the throttle so much, but Zach had it hooked up there. I really wish he didn't speed. That would have been a really good race. I think that would have came down to the last lap pass, maybe.
Yeah, I was thinking the same thing. Really looked like, you know, you were trying to size him up over the course of the first two runs, and that last run would have been great. Not meant to be. But your car, you know, you talked a little bit about it, getting loose there, yawing out there in the course, especially in one and two. We were watching that on camera a couple of times, almost dirt tracking around there, John. Were you adjusting on that truck during the runs, or you just stick with what you had?
Actually, I was practicing some last night, and I practiced a little bit today, and I was trying a couple different things on the setup, and probably about 5 seconds before I went to grid, I made a huge change to the setup, like springs and everything. Like, I had no idea what the setup was going to do once I hit the track, but it turned out to be all right. It was just a little bit too loose on that run there, but the first pit cycle I went in then and I tightened it up, but I didn't tighten it up enough. And then on that second pit stop we did there, I knew it wasn't going to be that long of a run, so I didn't even fool with it. I was like, I know it's good on a short run, I just need to keep it like that. Maybe I can, you know, field Zach there and I might be able to hold him off. But yeah, the thing was pretty I think it's pretty loose there, man. I'm not going to lie to you. It felt like I was running the street stock dirt track over there at Lanier.
Yeah, I'm sure it did. This series here, you know, at FTSR, we go green an awful lot with a 100-lap race, kind of broken up into 33-lap runs. Maybe didn't get to really see the tire wear issues of this new tire model. We didn't really get to see the tire rule. But talk a little bit about your strategy going into this race. Was it just to run a little bit extra in the first run, shorten those last two stints? Or were you thinking just follow the guys that are around you? What were your thought process there?
Yeah, honestly, the first five laps, I noticed I was pulling away from David Schildhaus there, which he was pretty much on the same setup as me, but not that close of a setup, but it was near it. I seen that man was starting to put some pace on third place there. I'm like, okay, well, I think we got something here. And then about lap 12 to 13, I see the guys are starting to slowly reel me back in. I'm like, okay, I'm going to have to try to do something here to, find some more speed on the track. So, I kind of upped my tape a little bit there, and luckily I wasn't overheating.
Did you decide to stay out a little bit longer on that first run just so you could shorten up those last two?
Yeah, I had about two laps left on fuel on that first run, and I could have went one more lap, but I decided not to, and Zach actually decided to pit the same lap I did, and I was seeing that me and him were pretty close there in the pits, and then I came back out, and then I got right back in front of him, and I passed up Bobby there. And then, out of nowhere, here comes Zach again. I'm like, man, I was like, I'm going to have to do something crazy on this last run here to even get a chance at this win. So that's why I short-pitted there on that last run. But he went in the pits right after me, and I was like, man, this ain't good. Why is he doing the same thing I'm doing?
Well, anyway, John, you did it all right, man. Zach trying to push the envelope maybe, sped a little bit, but great job tonight, man. We're really happy to see you back here, one of the original members at Full Throttle Sim Racing, man. Welcome back, doing it, putting a stamp on it with the victory, John. We couldn't be happier for you. Congratulations.
Hey, I appreciate it, Dean. I appreciate you guys putting on the broadcast too. This is really awesome. I know back in the day we really didn't have any broadcasts besides a few of them here and there, but it was rare. So it's really awesome to see this league getting some broadcasts, you know, and I'm just glad that there's this many drivers in the league too, because I know back in the day we only had like 15 drivers every week. So seeing this type of field is really awesome. Yeah, I mean, it's clean racing. I mean, as you can see, it went caution free the whole race there, so that's really awesome. So I'm just glad to be, you know, we're right here where I started at in sim racing. It's awesome.
All right, John. Congratulations again, Brad Patterson. That's John Adams, man, our race winner tonight.
Absolutely. He did a great job. I think everybody here at the Las Vegas Motor Speedway did put on a great race today. You had John Adams taking away the victory, Bobby Terrell second, Casey McMullen third, Lane Allen putting in a great show at fourth. But then you also had some people that really came from the back. Tim Bills putting in a sixth place finish coming from 23rd, seventh, Tyler Marble, James Torrey, Jeff Bratton coming back from the 31st to get a top 10 finish. Clean and green was the Knights, basically, word. And it really made it interesting. These guys had to really not only think about making consistent laps, taking care of their equipment, but also a little bit of strategy was put into it. And then, unfortunately, the issue with the 42 on pit road, Zach McDaniel, you know, it kind of wiped out what could have been. But, man, this, you know, FTSR, full throttle sim racing, this is going to be a great series. I can't wait till next week.
Yeah, man, speaking of next week, Wednesday, 9 p.m., the Blackwater Products USA Truck Series is going to continue. We're going to be at the Auto Club Speedway. Going to be some fantastic racing and, like, you know, green flag racing, man. You can't get it anywhere else. Anybody who's a good, clean racer, old school racer, come check us out, Full Throttle Sim Racing. And as always, come check out Full Throttle Television next Wednesday. We'll actually be on the air on Saturday night. We got Vidane Racing as well. And I look forward to watching those guys in the Super Speedway Series. But until then, folks, we'll see you next time here from Full Throttle TV.